What is up, first fans? Welcome back to another edition of our Coaching Changes episodes. Today we're going to be talking about the Atlanta Falcons and Arthur Smith, and kind of just a little bit about what we think is going to happen with this coaching change and what they'll bring over to the Atlanta Falcons.
Yeah.
What do you think, Devin?
Well, I don't really approve of this coach hire.
Wow, really?
He's a bad coach hire.
Wow.
Yeah. I don't think you should hire a head coach based off of your success as a coordinator. That's how I feel. Because you're almost bound to decline from that. It happens every single time.
Yeah, that is true.
So, I mean, the Tennessee Titans were top three offense the past 2 years, and that's why they hired him.
Based on efficiency, though.
Yeah.
Which Atlanta's been terrible at, so if he brings some of that to them, maybe that'll help them out.
A little bit, yeah. Maybe a little bit.
Because Matt Ryan's a good quarterback.
But it's not going to be anywhere near top three. That's not going to happen. That's bound to decline from that. And with Matt Ryan, you could absolutely have a powerful offense. I don't think that's going to happen.
Well, and their defense is pretty bad, too. So,
Which
is good for fantasy because they're going to be behind a lot and they're going to have to throw. And they have some weapons to throw. So,
well, I will actually say with Dan Quinn, that defense was terrible.
Mm-hmm.
After Dan Quinn left, that
it
defense
got a little better. Yeah,
it got a little bit better. So maybe this head coach will reignite that defense.
Yeah, it's quite possible.
Yep.
Although I just don't think they have enough good players to... I mean, you can scheme it in and make them closer to the middle of the pack, but I don't think they'll be a good defense.
Like their defense?
Yeah, their defense.
Okay.
Which is fine. Yeah. If you can get a top offense with a middle of the pack defense, you're going to be a pretty good NFL team.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I see that for them or not, but I think Arthur Smith could be a good hire, personally. Like I said, he did pretty good wonders with Tannehill.
Okay.
Which came from Miami and had a season that was pretty good, but other than that, not too great. And then once he got to Tennessee, he kind of took that over. And was that all him, or was it the efficiency? Was it because they had a run game?
I would like to add on to that.
Yeah, go for it.
After Tannehill was with Dan Campbell, and just watch one of our previous videos, I talked about that a little bit. He had a pretty good season.
Yeah.
But after that, he was with Adam Gase.
Yeah.
So,
which is not good.
No, not good at all. So after Adam Gase, he was with Tennessee. Maybe it was Adam Gase. He was a terrible head coach.
Yeah. Very true.
Yeah.
The other thing that I worry about with this offense is the run game.
Yes.
They've got one runner.
Yeah.
And we don't even know how good he is. He filled in decent last year, but he wasn't super efficient. He didn't have great... I mean, he got volume, which made him pretty good. And he's set up to get volume now, so he could be a decent number two running back as well. But I don't project him to be much better than that. And he is 28 years old, which is on the very peak of a good running back. He doesn't have a lot of wear and tear on him, which is positive, but I'm worried about that running game. And if Atlanta maybe even brings somebody else in to compete with him, one of these free agent running backs are still out there, or maybe another running back gets cut, they bring someone in. So, I don't know. We'll see.
Yeah, he's nowhere near Derrick Henry's size, so it's going to be very different.
Yeah. One other thing, too, about Tennessee is once Arthur Smith did take over for them, they made the playoffs for 2 years in a row. And was that Arthur Smith? Was that Vrabel? Was it a combination? But we just know that that was pretty good. So if he can bring that into Atlanta, who has some pieces but not enough, maybe they'll be all right. Got anything else to add to that, Devin?
No, not really.
Okay, perfect. Then we're going to move on. We appreciate you watching this video. It means a lot to us. If you wouldn't mind, if you just take the time to like the video, that helps us out in the YouTube algorithms. And then if you want to hear more videos in this series and other videos coming out throughout the season, we're going to have a whole bunch of content for you. Hit the subscribe button and click on notifications to let you know as soon as those videos come out. And we would greatly appreciate that. So, with all that being said, always remember to
finish first.
Thank you for listening to the FantasyFootballFirst.com podcast.
Jackson throws to Cleet. Crabtree has it for a touchdown.
We hope you enjoyed today's episode. Get more fantasy info and check us out at FantasyFootballFirst.com.